Hi all, welcome to the world of GK for learning general knowledge. Today, let's continue the topic derived units. Today, we shall discuss about energy, its classification and important points. Subscribe the channel, enable the bell icon to get all notifications. Let's start. Physics, energy. First, let's see the definition of energy. Energy is the ability of a body to do work. So energy is nothing but the ability of a body to do work. Unit of work. Unit of work is joule or newton meter. We can write both this units for work, either joule or newton meter. 1 watt hour is equal to 3600 joule. So 3600 joule is equal to 1 watt hour. The term energy was first coined by Thomas Young. Thomas Young is the scientist who coined the term energy. Device which converts one form of energy into another, transducer. So, transducer is the device which converts one form of energy into another. Next point is, law of conservation of energy was put forward by Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein is the scientist who put forward the law of conservation of energy. Now let's see what is law of conservation of energy. The law of conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but can be transformed from one form to another. That means energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. We cannot create an energy or we cannot destroy it, but only we can convert one form of energy into another form. That is law of conservation of energy. E is equal to mc square is known as mass energy equivalence, which shows the relation between matter and energy. So E is equal to mc square is known as mass energy equivalence, and this equation shows the relation between matter and energy. Here E is energy, m is mass, and c is the velocity of light. National Energy Conservation Day. National Energy Conservation Day is celebrated on December 14. Next, let's see about mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is the energy of an object occurred due to its motion. So, mechanical energy is energy of an object occurred due to its movement. Mechanical energy is divided into two, potential energy and kinetic energy. First, let's see what is potential energy. The energy possessed by a body by virtue of its position. So potential energy is nothing but the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its position. Energy stored in the water reservoir of a dam is potential energy. So the energy stored in the water reservoir of a dam is potential energy, and energy stored in a compressed spring, that is also potential energy. Potential energy of an object at rest on ground is zero. So, potential energy of an object at rest on ground, that will be zero. Potential energy increases as the height increases. So, potential energy is directly proportional to the height of the object. So, when potential energy increases, the height also will be increased. For an object thrown vertically upwards, potential energy increases and kinetic energy decreases. In case of an object, if we are throwing it vertically upwards, its potential energy increases. At the same time, kinetic energy decreases. When an object moving upwards, its potential energy always increases, and when it's coming down, its potential energy decreases. But in case of kinetic energy, the object is moving upwards, kinetic energy decreases because we are throwing that object. So its kinetic energy decreases. For a freely falling object, potential energy decreases as it approaches Earth. In case of a freely falling object, potential energy decreases as it approaches Earth. When it is coming to Earth, its potential energy decreases. And when it rests on ground, the potential energy will become zero. Now let's see what is kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, definition, the energy possessed by a body due to its motion. So, kinetic energy is the energy possessed by a body due to its motion. For a body of a mass m situated at a height h above the ground, potential energy is equal to mgh. Here, m is mass of the body and h is the height and g is the acceleration due to gravity. Potential energy is equal to mgh. For a body of mass m moving with a velocity v, kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Here, m is the mass of the object and v is the velocity. Kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. If velocity of an object is doubled, its kinetic energy becomes 4 times. If we double the velocity, its kinetic energy becomes 4 times. Because here it is mv square. Here v square and then if we double the value of v, the kinetic energy becomes 4 times. And if the mass of a moving body is doubled, its kinetic energy also doubled. And if we are doubling the mass of the body, kinetic energy also doubled. A moving bullet or a moving stone possesses kinetic energy. So, all the moving objects has the kinetic energy. A running train also having kinetic energy, running train or whatever it is, or all the moving object possesses kinetic energy. And kinetic energy is always positive. Kinetic energy is always positive. So that's all about today's topic. If this video is useful, please like, comment, subscribe the channel and share to your friends. Thank you.